We started with 104, 50 went out today, and only 10 remain. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, South Carolina, one more time, let's hear it for your top 10 at the Marathon Bassmaster Elite at Lake Murray. 10 Elite Series Assassins will battle it out. And this time tomorrow afternoon, we will crown our third Elite Series champion of 2023.
Love you.
You got this.
Thank you.
30 seconds.
Black Rifle K Cup. Brandon's got Red Bulls. We might get loose. Let's go, bull.
Let's get it.
Come on. Let's go see our... The mermaid.
Who's the mermaid?
Give us a bite today, Jack. Just staring. Let's go fish your points. Watch out, watch out, watch out. I said I need to fish docks. I said I need to fish docks.
Oh yeah.
God's good. Good morning, folks at home. We got started off with a 3 3/4. She's got a big head. She's kind of fat. Yeah, probably 3 3/4. Let's go, Brandon. We got one fish we need. I was just saying we're gonna have 2.5 hours today to catch 25 pounds. 2.5 hours. That 2.5 hours is going to be from 10 to noon. And we just caught a bonus fish. We just caught a bonus fish, so. That's going to be our window, though. It's going to be a grind when it gets to 10 o'clock. But if we can get a couple more of those before then, 2 6-pounders. Let's go, boys. Let's go, boys. I gotta slow down. I'm fishing too fast. And and she wasn't in the shallowest part. She was just off a little bit. Those fish a little bit later, they're going to slide up there to where you can't even hardly get to them. Just got to slow down, do our job, we'll be all right. I thought it was little. Did you? Did you think it was little when it came, like when I hooked it, I'm like, it's going to be one of those little ones. Yeah. We've got to fish everything in front of us and just go with it. Biggin'. Giant. Coming your way. You got this fish, Hunter. You got her. Just. Okay, you're done. Done this a million times, bro. That one's for you, Dad. Oh, I'm sorry. I just know how proud my dad would be right now. He loved watching us boys do this. Gosh. I'm sorry. Let's go, Brandon. What a bass. Things go your way. I'm 3 bites away from a blue trophy. Get it off the dock, rocks.
Just got some home decor.
I'm gonna make some pot pourri.
Pinterest specialty just barely just now showed your last fish.
Just now getting caught up.
I get caught up on weather and Ronnie and Tommy.
That was a little one anyhow. Looks like there may have been a bed right there. We didn't need that one dying on us.
Quick release.
Quick release. I don't even know if it was a keeper.
I don't think so.
14 inches. Biggin. Come on, Lord. Come on, Lord. She's behind two dock posts. She's under the boat. Here she comes. Here she comes. Get back, get back, get back, get back. Get, I'm talking clear back, bro. Clear back. Thank you. I'm sorry for screaming so early, but we're fishing for $100,000 and a blue trophy. I don't even care about the money, dude. Give me a hug. Give me a hug. Oh my gosh. Guys, if you don't have Berkeley Trilene, I'm telling you, you're missing out. This is 10-pound Berkeley Trilene. Look at where she's hooked. She's barely pegged in the back of her throat. We're gonna weigh her. I think that's an 8-pounder, 7. Oh my gosh. God is good. I'm sorry again. It's the biggest fish I've caught all year. What just happened? Guys, what just happened? I'm sorry, fish. I gotta get you in the live well. Hey, my body weight was in the boat. I kept my left butt cheek under my Lowrance unit. My Boat Logic's graph mounts keep me in. Dude, I had to stick my rod under the post, grab it.
And they say bass fishermen aren't athletes.
I kept all my weight in the boat. I know it's illegal to get your weight out of the boat. I made sure my buttocks was squeezing that graph. Rod, I think you're done for the day. Bro. I don't know what happened. We just did something though. I think we need to fish some docks. As Gerald Swindle would say, we need to be fishing some docks.
Golly.
At the Classic. He said that. Let's see what we got. I'm talking Magnum. Yep, I'm sorry. Let's just weigh them all. .365. So we're light on that, right? What did we say it was? Okay. So we're close. Yes, yes. 434 for number two. I am gonna put a call tag on this just so I know. Sounds dumb, everyone's gonna make fun of me. It also keeps the weight pretty close. Look at that bass. I don't know what I did to deserve that, but. It's a 7-pounder. It was a 703. I hit it in at 698. We're two bites away from winning. Still got to catch them. Still got to get. But golly, we got three fish for 15 pounds. Okay, this is that rod that just got toasted. I don't. What just happened?
I'm in disbelief.
Dude, that fish was clear on the other side, around the other dock post, and all I could think of was keep putting my line in a different spot so it didn't sit on the dock post at the same place. That's all I could think of is keep moving your rod post or your rod around. Just keep moving it around.
Quinto was walking on live mix, says that's exactly what he would have done.
Yes, I know. I watched that show so many times. Gerald knows how to fish a dang dock, that's for sure, and he knows. I need to be fishing docks, don't do dumb stuff. Just go do what you know how to do. If they ain't eating the top water, just go fish docks. Big one. Stay on. She's hot. Watch out. Okay. It's not that big, but. Yes! 3-pounder. Way down her throat. Let's go, baby. Oh, that's so big. Skinny, I know. I'm not going to complain now. Oh no. Oh shoot, it's only it says 284. 2¾. She's skinny. That's all right though, that's still good. I mean, it kind of makes up for it when you have a 7. Big head.
Good job, buddy.
Puts us at 17¾. So, yeah, 17.81. Thought it was bigger than that. That's all right. That's good. Just getting bites. We're getting bites. Actually, power pole down. It took a while for that one to bite it. I think it like pecked at it. Still need two big ones though. We got all day. All day. Gosh, dang it. Is in the brain. that means they're under the dock. You're fine. You're fine.
I'm gonna get them in anyway, please. Let's get that big one off this point over here.
Okay. I appreciate it. There she is. Gosh dang biggin'. Here this a little bit ago, they just didn't act right. So maybe, you know, there's gonna be another window to open up and we gotta capitalize on it. So trying to wait for this bird to, I don't really wanna hook a herring. I haven't had one blow up or sniff on the Chopo today. It's surprising, but it's bass fishing. That's what these things do. They just get, they get weird after a cold night, and now you got bluebird skies, not a cloud around. I'm still gonna fish this stuff in between some of the places that I've been fishing, the docks and stuff. Because it's worth a shot, but still just trying to keep an open mind on how to approach each high percentage place. Because like when I get a bite, it's not a surprise, it's almost expected. You just got to have enough of them to go through, and just need to trick two. You can see the bluebacks running down the bank right now. And I caught a 6-pounder right there in first day of the tournament. So kind of trying to stay keyed up. That's going to be the difference, because it's going to happen. It's just going to be, am I ready? Am I prepared for it to happen or not? So got really fortunate with a 7-pounder this morning. I'm sure everybody watched it. Just want to say hi to my wife and all my family. I know they're keyed up, so we're working on it. Just gonna keep grinding away. Got to find that window when they start again. That's been the key, is being in an area that there's bluebacks at. No surprise there. From what I could tell, it's not always everywhere. Just for whatever reason, there's big ones. Big ones. We haven't caught any little ones. And you know, if we have to get a bite, where could I go before the end of the day? Because I've seen it where these days just like this, and it's done. Like, what you did is done, and you make the most of what you had, but you still gotta have five. I'm just trying to think of the best area. I think it's 14 inches. Yeah, he ain't 14. He says, in your face though. And got a bite off that dock then. So I still keep them all honest, because I got to go past them. but it's just a grind. I gotta be on my toes. Anything could happen. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me to have another rodeo again. Just because where we're putting that bait at. Just need to borrow some off your dock, that's all. It's a good start. I need two more good ones, I feel like. Three would be great, but I definitely need two calls, so. I think it's just now starting to kick them in the head, I feel like, because be good to me. Come on. Been good to me all week. Giant. Keep that camera back. It ain't that big. I thought it's a dang giant. Well, it's bigger than what we got. I better not pull too hard. What do we got? It ain't even that big. It's just fighting like a giant. It is little. No? It's better than what we got. It helps. It helps. I get rid of, that's a pound something. Thought is a dang giant. It is a giant. You split up a seven. Know which one's gotta go. Not that one. Not that one. It's gotta be five. Four. Five. Yeah, that's a call. That's a call. Not much, but that's pounds. That's pounds. That makes our biggest one that we have to catch that much smaller. You know what I'm saying? Makes our biggest one we have to catch smaller. It's been a good dock. Thank you, Lord. I don't know what that weighs. I didn't even think about it, honestly. 2 1/4. And we had what? 1790 or 1890? Doesn't matter. I know I gotta catch more. Gotta catch more. Thank you, Lord. If I'd have lost that fish, I'd have swore up and down it was a four. I never seen it. I just, the way it pulled was hard. Sure does beat laying on a dock, doesn't it? Oh, come on, bro. Let's push through. 2 hours. Begging. Begging. Got to keep her pegged, Hunter. Oh my gosh. Please, Lord. We're stuck on a rock. I can't get to her. Stop, Hunter. Just stop. Just stop. Get the camera back. Way back.
I'm way back.
Way back.
Way back.
Way back. No, no, no. No, no, no. Yeah! Yes! Thank you, Lord! Woo! What a fish! What a fish! Come on, coach, put me in! Booby wants to spin! If you haven't noticed, that's a Friday Night's. Friday Night Lights reference, me and Brandon, the camera guy. We've been having movie references all day. I got a call. Put me in, coach. I want to win. Let me spin. All right, jump up here. Yes. Jump up here. I got a call. We need one more. We need one more. Toasted that rod, dude. 10-pound Berkeley Trilene. In your face. Are you kidding me? Okay. Let me look at my scale. We still got work to do. We're one bite away. All right, I didn't weigh that other one. So we got number four's probably, no, five. Oh, it's the last one we caught, right? Yeah, four and five. We'll beam them. Four. Yep. Six. Where's five? One. Or wait, wait, wait. It's got to be number six. Yeah. That's got to be it. So we got biggin. Biggin. We ain't leaving. Big in. So one, two, three, four. No. One, two. Stop. One, two, three. Yep, they're all bigs. Okay. And then we got number six is a small one. Definitely. I'm going to put it on a call beam. One super skinny. What's going on up there? Oh, that's the seat. Okay, four is bigger. And that one's bigger. Four is bigger. This one goes. Now we got over 20. What do you think that one is? 3 3/4? All right.
Regardless, it's over 20. You are now over 20.
I mean, we just make them have to catch them on a not so easy day. All right, we ain't leaving. We got one bite to go. Park your butt here and you fish. You fish your heart out and whatever happens, happens. That was a call. Do you think that was a two? Thank you.
What a moment.
I don't know how big that thing is though. Another rodeo. What did it have us at now? That's the cast. That's the cast. See, it's darker over here now, though. About to come back after this event, throw net over that fish up here. Just to grab it and then release it. Just to say I can finally catch it. All right, let's roll. Oh.
Oh. Oh my gosh.
One ate it. Oh my gosh, that was the winning fish. Oh my gosh, that's a winning fish.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
You're still in it. Catcher.
Dude, I drug it across the top because it was in the sun and she ate it off the surface. She hadn't come back. Oh my gosh. How do you not eat it? How do you not eat it? And I seen her shadow swim out. Oh my gosh, that was a grown one. Look, there it is. No, it ain't. Yeah, it is. Same size as that one we caught off of it. Oh boy. Dang.
Let's roll.
Seen one. I seen a dock that looked good over here. I marked it. I'm gonna bounce that, and then we're gonna go back to the place I had in practice. This fits the description. Going. All right, we're going 2.7 miles. Weigh in is 4 miles. We got 40 minutes, so it's going to be a 7 mile run back. It 225 run back, get that dock. Thank you. sure does feel good though, because we are hitting some high percentage stuff at the right time. I might go fish that bush. It looks good.
How would it feel if you won this tournament right now?
Oh, obviously that would be awesome. I don't think we did it. We're one bite away. But yeah, that's what this is what we live for right here. This is how you make stories. Whether it's a Tuesday night jackpot or a dang Bassmaster Elite Series event. All right, we gotta go. Something high percentage. Go hit those two stretches again. I can't go in that no wake zone because it's going to take us too much time to get back out either. So one bite. I needed one more.
Yeah.
I caught a 7.
Did you?
Dude, I had to put my rod under the dock and everything. It was pretty dumb. Wacky wormed him up.
Yeah.
John Cox style. No way. Shut up. Shut up. Dude, no way. That's too close. Drew's got it. Unbelievable. What do we got? We missed it. We got 21-2. That's probably what we got. And he's probably got like 25.
I don't know, man.
Oh my gosh.
I'm rooting for you.
Like the last top 10 I was in, they said don't look at the thing, so. second place.
I don't know, man. I wouldn't say that.
I'm just saying we weighed them. And if you got 24 pounds, you probably got 25. Because he's, like, literally, we are neck and neck.
I know.
That is a hell of a bag for him.
He's going to have,
you know what I'm saying? He's not over. We're dead on. Whatever. Dude, you're right. I mean, we did everything. Everything. Right.
And then there were three. Two left away. He is a former motocross racer. And if you watch Bass Live here this week, he has battled adversity, things that shouldn't happen, just keep happening, and has been working out right so far. He's a three-time Bassmaster Classic qualifier from Newcomerstown, Ohio, Hunter Shryock! Boom shakalaka, giant bass! Oh boy, this could get very, very interesting. Started the day with 64 pounds and 3 ounces, left the dock in second place this morning. He is looking for 22 pounds, 14 ounces as he tries to win his first ever Elite Series event. Looking for 22, 14. Five fish all alive. 21 pounds, 4 ounces. 21-4. He moves into second place, just 1 pound, 10 ounces short of the overall lead. With 85 pounds, 7 ounces. Get loud. Abu Garcia Pro Hunter Shryock had an incredible tournament. And with 85-7, man, it's unbelievable to think that this title is not going home with you. 85-7, an incredible weight. We're going to weigh this for Phoenix Boats. A big bass today needs to be better than 6'6 to take it away from Drew Cook. 6 pounds, 14 ounces, and a brand new Phoenix Boats Big Bass of the day. And, man, watching you, I mean, I think we all kind of agree. And if you haven't seen it yet, go check out Bassmaster social media. You may have had the catch of the year this morning. And it's hard to believe because every day I feel like I'm talking to you about the same things. But I'm watching you, the way you fished this week and the stuff you battled through, man, it was pretty inspiring and pretty incredible to watch.
Absolutely. You know, you guys witnessed it, and that's what I've been fishing around this whole week, and it's just kind of evolved. The first day was definitely all the Berkeley Chapo, the 105, got it done. I had 22 and a half pounds in like an hour, and then the next day I caught some off docks, and I didn't get as many bites, and then the next day it was more docks, and then today it was all docks. And when I say this much water, those fish were in that much water. That 7-pounder had me wrapped around three different posts, up under, had to reach under. If I didn't have 10-pound Berkeley Trilene on, fluorocarbon line, I would have never got her out. You guys witnessed it. It seesawed me. It was a complete circus. But, you know, the good Lord blessed me this week. I made a little bit work a lot because I had about a mile-long stretch, and there were just little key stretches in between that really, really paid off. And, you know, all week long, I lost two fish that mattered, and that's going to happen. There's everybody in the top 10 lost fish. Drew Britton caught all of his or a lot of them to put himself in that position, and, you know, that's all we can do. So I'm super happy with what happened today. Caught everything that bit, and, you know, that was my goal, to go out there and execute. And, man, it's a phenomenal fishery. I can't get enough of Lake Murray.
I think most of the anglers, or all the anglers in the field, echo your statements on that. I mean, I don't remember a tournament where we've had as many anglers pleading to come back on the stage, you know, through the entire tournament. But, man, being this close, how much does this motivate you going into Santee Cooper Lakes?
You know, absolutely. This is my best finish yet. I didn't even think I was going to be close. I knew I needed to have that 23, 24 pounds to get it done. So, you know, just to finish second, it is what it is. Like, that's still a great finish, but absolutely it's motivating. You know, it's just to get up here, and it's just a step in the right direction to be on the top spot. You know, that's what we all aspire to do, and it doesn't happen very often. You don't get these many opportunities throughout the year. So
You know, we got one, and we'll just keep trying to get after more opportunities and see what happens. Santee Cooper's awesome, but gosh dang, Lake Murray is on fire. I hope we keep coming back. Y'all just sign a contract for the next 10 years. We'll be good.
I sure hope we do ourselves. Let's hear it for him, ladies and gentlemen.